It's a Christmas tree.
Yeah.
Oh, you were asking her?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, are those M&M's on
there? Yes, peanuts. Christmas tree.
Usually she puts socks. Gumballs, and I don't like gumballs.
These are the ornaments. This is the wood.
Oh, I want this part right here.
Oh, you touched the cake, Ruthie?
Miss Michelle, look, these are the ornaments, and this is the wood.
What's your favorite? Or white frosting?
Lemon.
Lemon frosting?
Baba?
All lemon cake.
Baba?
What?
You don't like the marshmallow frosting?
Yeah.
That's marshmallow.
I do like the marshmallow.
So what kind of shake?
I want the trunk of the tree.
What kind of shake?
Shake.
You like Christmas trees?
You know what she likes?
Her soccer
I like these kind of sprinkles too.
Soccer field. Go wash soccer your hands, everybody.
She has like soccer field.
I want
like
kind of.
It
looks
like
they
have 10 M&M's.
I didn't even want to put
get
that.
Your face out of the picture.
It's so pretty.
Grandma, could I have one just like that for my birthday?
You like it?
Yeah.
In July? Well, of course, it's in July for your birthday.
Yeah!
You gotta die,
yeah.
Oh, see if I can. Like, your brother's in the
there's two candles out.
Two candles
I haven't had a cake raised like this.
So it's chocolate?
Stop reading.
He wanted chocolate with chocolate ice cream, but you couldn't make a chocolate Christmas tree.
Oh. Did somebody say?
No. But it's
Martha.
Andrew.
Are we ready? Happy
birthday to you. Happy birthday, Joe. Happy birthday, dear Andrew. Happy birthday to you.
Happy
birthday,
Joe.
You blew out half of them without trying, you wouldn't have a problem. Eat over your plate. You're really enjoying that cake, aren't you?
Quite a bit.
Oh, there's the M&M. Go ahead.
Chew it good.
Yeah, chew it good. There's a peanut in there.
Mmm, mommy.
Chew it good. There's a peanut in there. You gotta really chew.
Get a wash rag so we can.
I love you.
In a hurry.
Can you turn us down?
Hey, see, I'm gonna fall off. I just got the tail on the couch.
Look at me. Smile. Be careful. Don't go over the front.
Okay, but you have to stop rocking. Yeah, it is
me. It's me.
Look at me and stop rocking. Give me a big, huge smile. Okay, stop rocking.
I'm
not rocking.
Don't say me that. Jamie called. What the fuck is this tail
show? No, I can't find the talent show.
What is wrong?
Give me a big smile and videotape him, Ruthie. I took your picture.
Can you take me a picture?
Jared, get out of the way.
Can you take me a picture?
Yeah, next to Ruthie.
Give me a... Here, I'm gonna get on the... Here.
That wasn't a good smile.
That was so cute!
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Careful. Don't tip it. Don't tip it.
I know.
Watch what you're doing. You're tipping it. You're tipping it. I think that hangs on the nail there. Right there, see the little nail? There.
Mommy?
He dead?
Yeah,
I see my picture.
Have a kiss?
That's me.
May I please have a kiss?
Yes, that's me.
That's you. May I please have a kiss, you? Thank you.
May I kiss you?
And he had to live life as a human being. So he said he thought that the passage that told the Christmas story best was John 1. And he read that, and I thought that was very good.
That's so, good. But we're going to
okay, it was just a suggestion.
But you know what? The passage that would tell it would be your hometown and be accounted for. So Joseph went from the Galilean town of Nazareth up to Bethlehem in Judah, David's town, for the census. As a descendant of David, he had to go there. He went with Mary, his fiancée, who was pregnant. While they were there, the time came for her to give birth. She gave birth to a son, her firstborn. She wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger because there was no room in the hotel. There were sheep herders camping in the neighborhood. They had set night watches over their sheep. Suddenly, God's angel stood among them, and God's glory blazed around them. They were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I'm here to announce a great and joyful event that is meant for everybody worldwide. A Savior has just been born in David's town, a Savior who is Messiah and Master. This is what you're to look for, a baby wrapped in a blanket and lying in a manger." At once the angel was joined by a huge angelic choir singing God's praises. "Glory to God in the heavenly heights, peace to all men and women on earth who please Him." And the angel choir withdrew into heaven. The sheep herders talked it over. "Let's get over to Bethlehem as fast as we can and see for ourselves what God has revealed to us." They left, running, and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. Seeing was believing. They told everyone they met what the angels had said about this child. All who heard the sheep herders were impressed. Mary kept all these things to herself, holding them dear, deep within herself. The sheep herders returned and let loose, glorifying and praising God for everything they had heard and seen. It turned out exactly the way they had been told.
There were two red ones and the last one blue.
Well, you have my
happy
one.
What
was your favorite
stock?
You have your own
chain.
I'm happy with what I got.
Hey, put it back in your stockings. Don't put the books back in there. Leave those out. You got all the
Did you say thank you to Daddy?
Open it.
No, we're opening them one at a time. There aren't that many.
Ruthie's opening her.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, you'll go next.
I got it. I got it.
Yay! Oh, good. I like
it. Oh, yay! It's a ball!
Oh, Rosie!
These are just little extra things, so don't be disappointed. You know what the big one is? You didn't peek, did you? Yeah, don't drop it. Jedediah, what did you got? That's about a boy and a girl whose father gets lost in Alaska. I think it's based on a true story. And they go searching for him. Go ahead, Andrew. Honey, can she put her? Can you put her?
Look, it's a backpack.
Oh, well, that's a
backpack. Yeah. Just a minute.
I'm in a blue shirt too.
Time out.
She's teaching me how to do this.
Oh, you turn on and out.
Watch out.
Can I try it? Mom, can I try the door?
You don't touch this.
No. Can I try, Mom?
What do you think, Andrew?
You like that? You said you wanted a remote control.
Oh.
Okay, watch out.
Yeah, this is just like a remote control.
Hey, Ruthie, you cannot touch that, honey.
Yeah.
That is very fragile.
Come here, baby. Sit with me. And we'll play with your snowman. Yeah, this is number
four. Oh, remember we saw the snowman last night?
That's like a real train.
If you wanted to go forward or backward, you got to do those both at the same time.
Jared's present.
Okay.
Oh, he's
okay, that's enough. No, I don't want you. I don't want you listening to GR55 on it with those dimwits, because you're gonna have to be very selective. They evolve there sometimes.
This is my next present.
They use GD and.
What is
yours?
You
like that?
Hold on, Andrew.
Can you open up the little one?
Ruthie, Ruthie, come here. You got to open another one. Ruthie.
Those are number five.
Yeah. Ruth Joelle.
Oh, I have three more. I don't know.
You have
but those are okay. Together.
Okay,
right. Well, they're not.
No, Gina has Ruthie.
Does she have a number four?
This is beautiful.
Mama, am I supposed to keep the cake? Yeah.
No, okay, I got that for a
day. No, the wrong one. This is number four.
Gina, you opened up in the wrong order?
Yeah, this is number four. This is number three.
Oh,
we're going to have this off.
Hold on.
Hey, it's my right turn. There. Isn't it, Dan?
Yes, go ahead. Go. PlayStation. PlayStation.
Yeah, okay, back, Andrew, let's go. Let's get this show.
Can I have that?
Yeah.
Oh, DVD's going to CD holder?
Somebody get in this stroller or touch it. It's very fragile, okay?
Oh, it's got Notre Dame ending UCLA's touch rubber.
Don't let it drop.
I love that one.
Hey,
get her. She's
Let's get her.
Excuse me, move the stroller, please.
Jared.
Thank you.
Like hey, Jared.
So awesome. Awesome.
Don't let that drop on the floor, Bob.
I had no idea. I was not even thinking.
So don't break it.
I'm not going.
Okay, my dessert. She's off to the races.
I
tough getting older, isn't it, Gina?
Yes,
are you
kidding me?
This is so awesome!
Yeah.
You not know that?
You can do that, but
you
can take it. Those are a steak and a half, Gina.
How do you like them, Gina Marie?
Okay. I love them.
They've got clean uniforms on, Mom.
You see what she's doing like I do with her in the stroller?
Uh-huh.
That's not right.
Yeah, you
did you hear him? They have clean uniforms on, Mom. That's not right.
Mom, I'm pretty.
Do you like your baby? What are we doing next week? She goes, Mom, what are we doing next week? This is we don't do this again for another year, honey. Todd, ask her again.
Ruthie, did you like Jesus' birthday?
Ruthie.
Ruth, did you like Jesus' birthday?
Yeah. Isn't it pretty cool that you get presents on Jesus' birthday?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, and it also
plays.
That's a scooter.
Here.
You have to be bigger and with a helmet to do that.
You look like this, but you gotta have.
Ha! You like that?
You can't do that. You're too rough, Ruthie.
Too rough. We're gonna find out like all the BYOS toys, scooter, that.
She likes the dollies,
yeah.
Though, too.
Oh, yeah. That's the first thing. She just laughs at that.
Come on.
There's Papa. Happy, blessed, Merry Christmas.
Michelle.
Any special order other than how we did on the program. But Andrew is very courageous because it is hard to take a lead role. When you see Andrew doesn't get off stage, she's on every scene, he does not come off stage. There's no rest time for Andrew. And it was very courageous for him to take the lead part. It's lots of lines as you're going to see. So just my hands off to Andrew for doing that. Jedediah, very teachable. Teachable. That's the word that comes to mind when I think of Jedediah and everything, but in the play, very teachable. He needed some work when I first saw him in the beginning, and he just listened to the directions and just really was teachable. It was he's a blessing. Jake is my most improved. Jake is definitely the most improved. When he first got in here, I didn't think he'd ever even sit still, much less say line. And he's really greatly improved, and you're going to see it through his performance. He is definitely my most improved. If I was giving out awards, that would be it. Zachary is diligent in everything he does, and you're going to see this. His performance will speak for itself, but I just want to thank Zachary for his diligence. Carolyn, boy, what a great attitude. What a great attitude. She doesn't have a big part. Boy, she has a big, 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 great attitude.
Praise God.
Small part. She has a great heart. She's willing to do anything. A few of these kids are really like that. It's really nice to see it. Kayla, here's another one. Kayla doesn't have a big part, but but she wants to, she'll scrub toilets if I ask her to. So to be part of anything, to be with this team, she will do anything. She's, you'll see her in a lot of the scenes. She's willing to do all the scene changes and stuff because she's just the first one to go. When I say, who wants it? She's her hands up. You know, she just wants to be part. Jonathan too. You know, Jonathan honestly didn't want to be in the play too bad. You know, he's not saying, how much fun everybody's going to be in it. And I kind of said, you know, I'll give you a small part. You know, I'll give you make sure. And I gave him a small part. But behind the scenes, he's doing a lot. And he's so willing. And it's just so, such a blessing. Gina Moser. The poor girl needed one more thing to do. Because her work schedule is just crazy with school. I've never seen somebody work so much for school. Not to mention she works. Not to mention she's in a house with seven children. But I'm so thankful for her that she was willing to do it because she did not have to. And she still wanted, even though she's the oldest of our children now, she wanted to be in the play. And I was really blessed that she was eager and is in the play.
You cast Melanie.
No, I didn't. Oh, okay. Rebecca and Melody, I kind of got to put together because Melody and Rebecca are the reason we're doing the play, because it was them that I saw doing the acting out and everything, and it was them that took the initiative to look for a play that I would like, and Melody put the programs together. The programs you see here, thank Melody for that. She's very creative in a lot of things. Melody is a highly talented girl, and you'll see that in her performance as well. But both Melody and Rebecca were very eager to do anything and everything to make sure the play goes on. And so I give them thanks for that, and you'll see they have great performances. And Jared, where's my Jared? Jared is, if it wasn't Jared and Zach, both my young ones in the play, I had some tough times starting this play out. I got to tell you, their smiles and their attitude has really helped me through some tough times. Jared has such a great attitude, always smiling and everything. I used to have to look for him and say, okay, now I have to get it together. Because he was just such a blessing and just so willing and so happy, and we'll definitely see that in his performance. And last but not least is Brother Miguel, who actually came on late. Gino was going to play Jacob Marley, and I really wanted less for poor Gino. And I asked Miguel to do it not more than, I don't know, 3 weeks ago. And he took it on right away. Didn't even, like, give it a second thought. He eagerly said, yes, I'll do it. And that was such a blessing. But even more than that, this man behind the scenes has pulled... I mean, I needed somebody. Normally when you do a production like this, you get somebody who does it separate. I don't have to worry about any of that. I didn't have that. I had to do both. And when he went back there to do the part, I didn't ask him. I didn't anything. He took it, and he just did it, and he organized back there. So when you see the quietness and the scene changes that are going so effectively, you thank Brother Miguel, because it's because he's behind there. And he really came in, and he is just what I would say is a godsend, no exaggeration. And I just want to thank Miguel for his servant error. And, one other thing happened today that really touched me. We had prayer time where you guys were in here. We had to go over a few things, and then we had our prayer time. And you know, the kids, 8 out of 11 kids said a prayer. I didn't ask them to. I said, only if you want to, feel led to pray, you pray. 8 out of 10 of those kids said a prayer, very heartfelt prayer. And they just want to bless you right now. That all they want to do is bless you and bless God first. They know this play is that the star of Christmas is Jesus. And their performance is doing unto him. And so I just want to welcome the Purpose Driven Christmas Carol. There's cookies and coffee after the play when it's over. And I just hope you guys enjoy the play as much as I enjoy watching these kids do it.
Humbug.
Christmas? A humbug, Uncle? You don't mean that, I'm sure.
I do. Merry Christmas? What right do you have to be merry? You're poor enough.
What right do you have to be dismal? You're rich enough.
Bah, humbug.
Oh, don't be so cross, Uncle.
What else can I be when I live in a world full of fools such as this? Merry Christmas, indeed. What's Christmas time to you but a time for paying bills without money? A time for finding yourself a year older and not an hour richer. If I can work my will, every idiot who goes about with Merry Christmas on his lips will be blue with his own pudding and buried with a stake of holly through his heart. Much good Christmas has ever done you.
I believe Christmas has done me a great deal of good, Uncle, whether I've profited materially from it or not. And
charity. I should be quite content on my own. Now you've done your good deed. Be off, and good afternoon.
You won't spoil my Christmas, Imago. The invitation was sincere. A Merry Christmas!
Bah!
And a Happy New Year!
Humbug! Mr. Marley died 7 years ago, this very night.
We have no doubt his generosity is well represented by his surviving partner.
What do you want?
At this festive season of the year, Mr. Scrooge, it is more than usually desirable that we make some provisions for the poor, who suffer greatly at this time.
Are there no prisons?
Oh, plenty of prisons.
And the workhouses? Are they still in operation?
They are. I wish I could say they were not.
I'm glad to hear it.
A few of us business people are endeavoring to raise a fund to buy the poor some to eat and drink and a means of warmth at this time of year when want is so keenly felt. You've been blessed with so much. Why not use it to do some good in the world? So, how much shall I put you down to?
Nothing. I support the prisons and the workhouses with my taxes. Let the idle poor go there.
But many would rather die.
They'd rather die, they'd better do it and decrease the surplus population. Good day, ladies. You want the whole day off tomorrow, I suppose.
It's quite convenient, sir.
It's not convenient and it's not fair. You think yourself ill-used if I stopped your wages for the day, but you think nothing of having paid day's wages for no work.
It's only once a year, sir.
A poor excuse for picking a man's pocket every 25th of December. Very well. Be all here earlier the next morning.
I will, sir. Thank you, sir.
Only a dream, Ebenezer.
You're very real for a dream. Why are you here?
I have much to tell you of great importance. Sit down, Scrooge. You're not a very happy man, my friend. You're miserable, and you make all who come in contact with you miserable.